This video is about the stippling fill type. In general, its usage is very simple. You can just select an object and set it to stippling. The stippling pattern is then automatically generated and the object is filled. You may also start with an old design and change its look completely by applying the stippling fill. Stippling is an auto-generated pattern which can be used in any fill object. Stippling is mainly used for decorating purposes, as in this design. It can also be used for holding different quilt parts together. So, suppose we have this quilt design. We can then use stippling to create a decorative net on top of the design. Let's see some of the stippling options. Using density, we can specify the distance between the lines of the stippling pattern. Using length, we can define the maximum stitch length of the pattern we've chosen. If you zoom in and use the measuring tool, you will see that the actual stitch length may be less. This is because the stippling pattern is turning, so the software uses the optimum stitch length in order to follow the pattern. You can also decorate the stippling lines using any style of stitches. By using offset, you can move the stippling fill to the inside or outside. Actually, you may choose to make it somewhat larger to allow for the pull of the embroidery on the fabric. Otherwise, you may choose to make it smaller so that the stippling pattern is completely inside the shape. Finally, using break apart, you can turn this stippling pattern into a line pattern, so that you can edit freely if you like. Break it into subparts and possibly change its shape using the node editor.